Hello children, myself Shubhaya Patil Kulkarni. I am going to continue chapter 10 quadratic equations. Already I solved in 10.2 exercise first main questions by using factorization method. Second main, they gave all the problems which is given in the example 1. In example 1 in textbook, you observe example 1, some two statements they give. First one statement, they convert it to equation form, that is standard form of quadratic equation. So statement they convert it in this manner, that is the equation has become x square minus 45x plus 324 is equal to 0. So this equation I have to solve by factorization method. So how to solve? Method is same for each other. Here no number means 1 is there. 1 into 324 you multiply, 1 into 324 you multiply and write 324. You have to split this number. When you multiply two numbers you should get 324, when you add or subtract you should get minus 45. So the 324 is some large number, it is so I will check by factors now. So you use this factorization method, you know, 324. See now, 2 1s are 2, 12 it becomes 2 6 are 12, 2 2s are 4, 2 8s are 16, 2 1s are 2. Then 81 is there, so then 3 2s are 6, 3 7s are 21, 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9. These are the factors now. So in these factors only, if you multiply all these factors children, you are going to get anyway 324 only. But for multiplication no problem. In these factors only I have put two groups. When you add or subtract you should get minus 45 as answer. So now you check now, 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27. 27. 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 12. Yeah, so 12 means it becomes, no, it can't become. So 3 4s are 12. 12 3s are 36. 36 plus 9 is there. So if I add 9 plus 6, yeah, 45. And 9 15, 45 it becomes 11. See now, these four factors you do. 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 18 2s are 36 children. So these two factors into one group, 3 3s are 9. So if it add both, minus 36 minus 9 is minus 45, it becomes there. So if you multiply 36 and 9, you are going to get anyway 324 only. So in this manner I can split now, minus 36 into minus 9 is nothing but plus 9 plus 324 only it becomes. Okay, the same numbers if I add children, see minus 36 minus 9, when both the numbers they have minus sign, you have to add it to the same sign. So minus 36 minus 9 is minus 25 children. So in this manner I can split the middle term there, that is now the first term as it is writing. The middle term only you have to split in that manner children. Minus 36x minus 9x. The last term also you write it as it is equal to 0. So now after writing this much step, you do two terms one group. Then in these two terms x is common, you take out as a common. Then 1x remains x minus 36. Here in these two terms you take minus 9 as common, then x minus, if you multiply 9, 36 the 324 it becomes. So now you equalize to 0 children. Now see, you observe here this factor and this factor, in this term this factor, and in this term this factor, same factor. So same factor you take as a common, x minus 36. X minus 9, the remaining factor is equal to 0. Only equalize to 0. X minus 36 is equal to 0.
are x minus 9 is equal to 0. X is equal to 9 are x is equal to 36. We got the answer. So this is in second main first question.
Actually, example sums means first one we give statement problem and that statement they converted to equation form. That equation form I solve for x children. So the statement is John and Jivanti together have 45 marbles. Both of them lost 5 marbles each. And the product of the number of marbles they now have is 124. We would like to find out how many marbles they had to start with. So they have to start with the marbles. That is 9 children. They converted statement problems to the equation form and I solved the value for x children, that is the number of marbles. From how much number they have to start the marbles. Okay, so the x value is 36 are x value is 9. Then the inner only this main only children. The second question is that write down this much. Children, same time, another one statement is there in example 1. That this statement they converted to equation form. That equation is in this form, that is, it is in the form of standard form for equation. That is x square minus 55x plus 750 is equal to 0. Okay. The 715 number, no number. So 1 into 750 is equal to 751. This number I have split now. How I can split now? So 750, for 750, you find out the factors for 750 children. So last 0 is by 5 number, it will go out by 2 also, it goes. So now I am going to consider 5 table, 5 ones are. 15, 5 6 are 30, 3 2 are 6. So, but when I add and subtract, I should get, see, if you multiply all these factors, you are going to get 750 only, children. But in these factors only, I have arranged the factors in that manner. When I multiply, when I add subtract, I should get minus 55. So, now I have to check now. So, which is stable if I use it? Factors if I multiply, I am going to get minus 55 children. Yeah. 5 are 25. 5 are 15. 2 are 30. Yes. I can get it in this manner, children. See now, 5 are 25. These two factors, one group. And these three factors, one group, if I do it. 5 are 25. Minus 25, you take it. 5 are 15. 2 is 30 minus 30. If you add, you are going to get minus 55. If you multiply all the factors, then anyway you are going to get 750 original. So you can use it in this manner. Minus 25 into minus 30 is equal to plus 750. And the same values if you add, you are going to get minus 55. So in this manner, you split the middle term. First term as it is divided, so this is minus 25x, only middle term is split in this manner, minus 25x minus 30x plus 750 is equal to 0. In these two terms, which is a common term, x is common in both, so you take it as a common, x minus 25, then minus 30 you take it as a common here, then it becomes like this original. See now, if you multiply 30 into 25, you are going to get the 750 only. Then once again you observe your also x minus 25, your also x minus 25. X minus 25 you take it as a common factor, then x minus 30 becomes, it remains, this also, these two other factors. Now both the factors equalize to 0. X minus 25 is equal to 0.
or x minus 30 is equal to 0. X is equal to 30 or x is equal to 25. This is a quadratic equation, so it will be handy to solve two values for x children. So this is in this example 1.
Second statement is, in this manner children, a cottage industry produces a certain number of toys in a day. The cost of production of each toy was found to be 55 minus the number of toys produced in a day on a particular day. So the total cost of production was Rs. 750. We would like to find out the number of toys produced on that day.
So produced on that day maybe 25 or maybe 30 children.
Okay, so they converted statement problems to equation, standard form of quadratic equation form. Then we solve by factorization method for a variable, that is what we had to find out. We have taken it as x and we got the value for x children. So in this manner, we had to find out the solution for quadratic equation by factorization method. Okay children, write down. Children,
in 10.2 exercise only, third basic question is in this manner. Find two numbers whose sum is 27 and product is product is 180. Okay, so now we consider find two numbers means what I have to find out. Let those two numbers be X and Y. So then, whatever I take that value, if I find out, then that is the answer. Find the two numbers since I have taken, let those two numbers be x and y, whose sum is 27. So that is, whose sum is, those two numbers sum is 27. X plus y is equal to 27. So then, out of this, so now I have to convert y value should be there. X is x only. Y, one number it becomes, then y is equal to 27 minus x. So the one number out of these two numbers, one number is x and another number is 27 minus x, it becomes 7. Then, and product is 182. So one number is x and the another number is 27 minus x, 7. Find two numbers whose sum is 27 and product is 182. So if I consider product now, see now, one number is x and another number I have got it now, 27 minus x. So the product of those two numbers is 182. Now you simplify now by multiplying, okay. So x into 27 is 27x, plus into minus is minus, x into x is x square. 182, I take it this side, it becomes minus 182 is equal to 0. So we have to arrange now. All these three terms are not in the form of standard form of quadratic equation. So I will arrange it now. I take it all these three terms because first term negative it is there. So if I take it that side, it becomes positive. So it becomes x square minus 27x. I am taking that side. So sign changes. Minus it becomes plus. Plus it becomes minus and minus it becomes plus. 182 is equal to 0. Now the same method, splitting method. 182 you split and find out the factors of this. 2 nines are, 2 ones are. Then in which table? 7 ones are, 7 threes are. Okay. So now which number you will choose it? 7 twos are 14. And 3. These two factors you put as one group children. Another number is 13. So it is 27. Okay, I think square minus 14x minus 13x plus 182 is equal to 0. Out of these two terms, common is x here, x minus 14, minus 13 to take out common in these two terms here, then it becomes x minus 14 is equal to 0. You take out x minus 14, x minus 14 common, x minus 14 and x minus 13 is equal to 0. Both equalize to 0, you get the value. X minus 14 is equal to 0 or x minus 13 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 14 or x is equal to 13. Therefore, children, see now. X is equal to 13 or 14, I can take it. So because, see now sum of these two numbers is 27 only. X value I put it to 14 or 13. Another number, then. Another number it becomes day 4. This is one number. The another number is y. Y is 27 minus x. So if I take it x value 14, then see 13 it becomes y value. So sum of those two numbers is 27 and the product of those two numbers 14 into 13 is nothing but 182 children. So they told for us to find those two numbers. We got the value of those two numbers. Be careful that they give you statement, read statement properly according to the statement. What we have to find out, let that those two numbers be, we have taken two variables and we have found the value of those two variables children. So in this manner you have to solve the statement problems. You have to reduce the standard form of quadratic equation. Then you have to solve by factorization method children. Okay, write down. Children, in this exercise only, fourth question is in this manner. Fourth main, find two positive integers. Find two positive integers. Integers. Sum of whose squares. Sum of whose squares is 365. Okay. Find two consecutive integers. Consecutive positive integers means one after one number. Consecutive one after one number only. After one, two, like that way. So if I consider that one number be x. If I add 1 to that next number, I will get it. So, let 2 consecutive positive integers be x and x plus 1. Sum of whose squares is, sum of whose squares means squares of this, x square plus x plus 1 whole square is equal to 365. Okay, so now you arrange it, now you according to identity a plus b whole square, you expand this, x square plus 2 plus b square minus 365 is equal to 0. This 365 I take in that side. x square, like terms here also. Power 2 is the root, so those two are like terms. So like terms you can add it. 1x square plus 1x square is 2x square. Plus 2 ones are 2 into x is 2x. Plus 1 square is 1 only. Minus 365 ones are 2 eights are 2 twos are is equal to 0. So now how I can split this minus 182 then? When I multiply, I should get 182 minus 182 children. So 182 take your form factors now. 2 nines are, 2 ones are, 3 twos are. Yeah? 3 twos are, 7 ones are, 7 ones are, 7 twos, 7 threes are. Yeah? 7 twos are 14 and 13. Becomes 1, it comes in between. The middle number value is 1, so I can choose it in this manner. But when I multiply, I should get minus 182 means now 182 minus 182, I can split in this manner, children. That is plus 1, I should get means the bigger number should be plus, and this is the minus. So if I multiply plus 14 and minus 13, I am going to get minus 182, children. Then 14 minus 13 is 1, children. X square first term as it is divided. The next this one is plus 14x minus 13x minus 182 is equal to 0. So out of these two terms, in these two terms you take out common x plus 14. Here you take minus 13 as common. X plus 14 is equal to 0. So if I consider like this way, then common factor you take out as common, x plus 14, the remaining factor is x minus 13 is equal to 0. Okay? Then, so if both equalize to 0, x plus 14 is equal to 0, or x minus 13 is equal to 0. X is equal to minus 14, or x is equal to 13. Okay? 14 or 13 I don't know, children. But I have taken a two positive positive integers means x and x plus 1. So when x of positive positive integers means I have to consider positive value. One value I got in negative, so I have to consider positive value for x. Therefore, one number x is equal to 13, children. The next concrete positive integers is x plus 1. That is 13 plus 1 is equal to 14. So another number it is. Okay? Another number. That is 13 and 14 other numbers. Find two concrete positive integers. Sum of two squares is 365. So if we will square it and if we will add it, 13 square plus 14 square and if we will get it is 5. 5 2 consecutive positive integers, sum of 4 squares is 365. If you substitute and if you simplify, you are going to get 13 square plus 14 square is equal to 365, children. So those two numbers, consecutive positive integers, are 13 and 14, children. In this manner, by factorization method, you have to solve for quadratic equation form. Okay, children? Thank you, children. Practice maths daily. Okay? Bye. All the best.